More than 400 years ago, Mughal Empress Nur Jahan brought a delicate hand embroidery from Central Asia to India. It took firm roots in Lucknow and its surrounding areas and came to be known as Lucknow Chikankari. While Chikankari enjoyed the patronage of the Nawab of Oudh, it fell into disarray soon after, leading to a fall in the quality of work, low wages for the artisans, and a distorted market structure. Almost a century later, the struggle for revival and recognition began.
जब आपका चिकनकारी है तो ये तभी होगा जब तक इसका कानूनन अधिकार आपको
नहीं मिलेगा।
वो है आपका इसका लोगो।
Needs spearheaded this movement, organizing artisans into groups, training them and preparing them to pitch for geographical indicator under intellectual property rights.
फर्क ये पड़ा कि हमको 36 टाके पहले नहीं आते थे वो 36 टाके हमने सीखे इसलिए जो पहले टाके नहीं आते थे तो एजेंट हमको देता था वो उसी हिसाब से पैसे देते थे 2003 में हमने चिकन के ही बल पे अपना घर बनवाया था उसके बाद 2007 में हमने इसी चिकन के बल पे अपनी शादी की थी
सिखलाने ना केवल उसको क्राफ्ट को सिखलाते हैं बल्कि हम लोग मार्केट एक्सपोजर भी देते हैं कि कहाँ कच्चा माल मिलेगा और कहाँ अपने प्रोडक्ट को तैयार प्रोडक्ट को सेल करेंगे
तो कम से कम 1000 महिलाओं का एक ऐसा संगठन बनना चाहिए एक ऐसा जत्था बनना चाहिए कि जब हमारा ये माल जाए बाहर तो जैसे हम कहते हैं ना कि टाटा का नमक लाओ उस कंपनी बना लेंगे हम और उसका नाम ही रहेगा चिकनकारी महिला प्रोड्यूसर कंपनी
unless until we keep artisan right at the center no GI tag will carry any kind of meaning
We bring you personal stories of three women and their interface with chikankari.
This local market near our office, where she used to go every day and check out stuff.
Every day, my
almost every day, and that guy over there, madam, आज न्यू स्टॉक नहीं आया है. आप एक वीक बाद आना. And she, I think she had the contacts of all those local sellers there, and you know. Very regularly मैं उसको देखती थी इतना a bunch of clothes every week she used to get stuff for us or maybe her roommates and all she used to get stuff from there so तभी she was very passionate about you know
sometimes people get scared of her because you know they have this thing that she is that aura you know that because she is very bold by nature and she doesn't shy away from telling her opinions which is a very good thing so a lot of people get scared of telling their opinions to her even if she's wrong
finally shruti decides to quit her corporate job and return to lucknow and begin to work with a fair trade section at neev which is headed by her mother she launched her own brand zarchi combining the words zardozi and chikankari the famous crafts of uttar pradesh
I think it was only during this gi and the patent and I was in college second year here in it when I finally could appreciate the craft seeing my parents do it and I had the nudge to come back it was in 2013 and I was still with crystal and I spoke to my father and he was like you need to get more corporate experience and that was when that I started doing some extra hours of work in Bombay itself so for Saturday and Sunday I used to volunteer for a startup weekend program
like the need is an organization which I've been doing multiple jobs all together definitely leads to a development impact but she came out with a very focused area of her attention that is where she you know wants to grow and excel herself
And once I got married, I think it was Vivek who finally, you know, kicked me that you can just go and do it. It'll be too late in life if you try after 10 years after having a family. At the same time, we had a lot of buyers from abroad approaching us for samples and buying, you know, bulk products from us. So once I started to come back, the first thing that I thought was, why not build a brand and then sell, rather than me selling women artists, and why not give them a name that this is the group that does, this is the identity and this is what it looks like. What we're trying to do is, one of our constant buyer from Australia wants to experiment with embroidery on dolls. And I looked up the market, we haven't done it as yet in the Lucknow region or the Chikankari ambit. It becomes difficult because she wants it to be a shaded embroidery, and the 31 or 32 stitches of chicken embroidery does not have that shaded bit. So it's tricky for them, but we are experimenting. This small 5x5 will probably take the whole day because she will be doing, and then this patch needs to be cut and go on the towel, and this will be done by the Zardozi embroiderer. So this is done twice by hand. So we are looking up at other samples, how embroidery is. So this is probably from Russian embroidery, which is very texture and has painting. So we need to take a lot of inspiration from Russian and Turkish, which is not Chikankari at all.
She came out with a two popular craft, which UP has got in a huge numbers, and particularly related to our Lucknow craft is Lucknow Chikankari. The other one also goes at the same par is Zardozi now. In between, her husband transferred to London, UK, so obviously she had to go there. But she was still continuing with the same esprit. Though she transferred to London, but she was restless. Yes, something we need to also do it over there now. Then she came in touch with some fair trade potential buyers also, the fair trade organization also. So we thought that this is the way we can have a very fine linkages from the products of our Chikankari and Zardozi to a very macro level kind of our market opportunities through Shruti. And now the time has come where I could see that, yes, she seems to be passionately coming forward in order to ensure that a very huge number of employment generations are created.
So one of the easiest way when you're traveling and you want to grab eyeballs, and also because you believe in the product, you know, forget that, is wear your own product. I think that's the foundation of it all, wear your own product. So I try and always carry my own bags. Also, when I'm on trek or hike, I make sure I'm in my hat, you know. And we have got so much of response on this hat. They were not ready to improvise because I wanted to deviate from the monotony Chikankari has, and I wanted to do some, you know, innovative designs. And they were not ready in villages. They were like, we are used to doing this flower and leaves, and that's all we know. Because they're so blocked of the designs they get and the exploitation of the hand of middlemen that they don't want to, you know, expand beyond that. Also, their belongings to the craft is very, very less. So what I'm trying to do is, last time when I started, it's been almost a year, that ask them to take their own decision of colors. Irrespective of the fact it goes wrong or right, just take your own decisions, own it up. You have to have certain amount of ownership. It was a learning on my part also on how to change my dialect and how to coax them to do something else, which might work in corporate, but which will not work here. The idea was that every time they weave a carpet, which is really popular in the Bourbon, with the Bourbon women in the mountains in Morocco, the extension is rolled such that it looks like a thick pom-pom, a thick ball. So I just took that idea away to make it into something jute dust bags where we could, you know, fix the pom-poms. It might look chic, and it at the same time serves a purpose of storage bags. Just a cushion cover. Oh. But these stick with my generation very quickly. Companies which do wine manufacturing or bottles. So for gifting or corporates. So this is a wholesale sample that we did.
Chikankari had evolved as a home-based craft done by women during leisure. Deadlines had never been a part of its structure. But within her sphere of influence, Shruti is changing the rules of the game. She needs to meet the demands of a timeline-driven market.
we are trying to start our 5 women tailoring group as well here, full-fledged on salary basis. We have a small group in Chikankari that comes full-time. So what I also wanted was, often women in Chikankari work from home, A, because a lot of family members don't want them to go out, B, because they haven't done it, so they don't want to come out. So what I wanted was some women who are allowed to come out should come in a professional setup and should work professionally so that they take their work seriously. We decided, let's make a WhatsApp room and start selling their products directly to our own friend circle, just to see the responses.
Her husband recently got scandalized. I still don't understand how can the same thing fit you and fit her.
It does.
Yeah, like, wow.
So, when we, I and Swithi were in college and we were exchanging stuff and we knew that we have similar taste in things, so we would hide that stuff. Or we played it, don't pick that and pick everything else. So yeah, we have gone. Now we're in the stage yet. We don't want to have the crowd. We want the best artisans. So they went under an exam. If at all somebody has to come, we will again hold a second line of exam somewhere around agle saal, next year sometime. Earlier we struggled because people were not willing to come out of their houses, you know. Or the ones who already come are run in a sweatshop sort of fashion. So we didn't want it. We wanted a very professional sort of fashion. We decided that we'll start small, even if it's 2 women, 3 women, we'll start small because people, you know, news travels. Once they see, they'll realize the benefit. And so we decided that if somebody is coming from a little far off, we'll pay the conveyance charges. So whatever the auto charges, we decided we'll shelve that. Because they're women, so we need to be careful about, you know, we need to own that up. By profit model, when I say profit model, I think it can be misconstrued a lot of times. When I say profit model, I mean that they should get the benefit of the real price. When we get through a lot of middlemen, there is very little profit that percolates down to the roots. Right, so I think this is the chance that I'm playing on, that this bit we have to invest to make them a fine artist.
Shruti decided to give her Chikankari unit a boost, not by building on the same designs, but by diversifying the handwork and products, bringing together influences from around the world, which she was exposed to by this time.
Fashion was something that was on my mind. I wanted to do something which was creative. I wanted to get creatively involved. And which, when I say that I was thinking of all these things, it is the pre-internet time. So awareness level or the access to information was difficult. So that was the year NIFT had introduced specialization specific masters, PG diplomas.
Shipra Anand post-graduated from the National Institute of Fashion Technology and returned to Lucknow to pursue a career in fashion design. She now accommodates Chikankari into both fashion design and fashion academics.
Then when I came back, then it was like, now what to do? Choices were, there were only 2 types of fashion thing happening in Lucknow at that time. Either there were family-owned chicken businesses who've been there since generations, or there were garage boutiques. The third thing that came to my mind was fashion academics, because there was nothing happening. Because at that time, Lucknow market in terms of fabric, availability, and everything was a little difficult. Whatever was happening, with all due respects, but we knew it's not up to the mark. Counselings that I was taking counselings at schools, I was taking counselings at personal counselings as well. And then somehow that one office came up that okay. And then those counseling sessions evolved into grooming sessions as well, pre-competition grooming. And we established Academy for Fashion Careers. this AFC started, and then AFC, by God's grace, it grew. We did our best, honest job, and the results spoke for themselves. Then by that time, more Niftians were going, thanks to AFC, more Niftians were going to NIFT and other colleges like NIFT Mohali and all that. And some of them were even coming back. So then we had good faculty resources as well. People were ready to share their knowledge. So we got them together at the same platforms. We were providing good quality education. But then we did feel the need for further national level platform, because exposure is important. In this field, you can't sit in one corner of the country and just think the world comes here. Then we decided, let's expand the, we had already now gotten into fashion education by now. So we went ahead and we started with our own brand, Estelle Fashion Academy in Lucknow. And we had gotten an affiliation as well from one of the deemed universities. We got together with JD Institute Fashion Technology. It's like now the students had access not only to industries and the fashion show in Delhi, they even have access to internship at UK in London. There is a branch of JD in London. So it's like now the students in Lucknow, sitting in Lucknow, whoever can afford, we can give them that exposure, we can give them that accessibility. So we do feel happy that we are doing something which is pretty genuine. And today, there's so many Lucknow JDians out there in the market, in Lucknow, outside of Lucknow, NCR, even till Mumbai, who are doing so well. Parallelly, since 2002 onwards, I have also been working closely with NGOs of Chikankari and Zardozi. This gave me a lot of insight into the lives of artisans. Parallelly, we would visit interiors and we would work closely. Zardozi is majorly men folk who are doing it, and Chikan is majorly women folk who are doing it. Then with the Chikankari, since I did have an access to artisan base, there did come a time where we were toying with the idea, okay, let's get into Chikankari. So for us, what was more feasible was getting into a breadth segment and catering to a market. But then in that case, all that happened was whenever there was a commitment, we realized that we are totally dependent on the artisans' adherence to time and quality, respect towards time and quality, that we will be able to deliver further. So that made us very vulnerable. And artisans, it's not a no complaints as such. They are also in their own environment. These are the women folk who are doing everything for their house. They're doing their household chores, and then after that, whenever they find time, they're doing the embroidery. As long as you're doing a project, you're creating prototypes for a project for another organization, for a third organization. Those risks are not involved directly. So then you enjoy working with that women folk segment. If you don't finish today, koi baat nahi, we finish 2 days later. But if you are now using the same workforce to create commercial product, to cater to market, committed delivery timeline, then it becomes difficult to handle. We explore a lot, even we inspire our students to explore a lot through Chikan. And a lot of them are working in the industry with Chikankari people, because now even the family-owned businesses who had very closed door policies till now, they've also realized the need of hiring designers. And study of design deals with market, deals with aesthetics, it deals with trends, it deals with client study, it deals with innovation, improvisation. So there are so many things. The fact is that the end product ka cost hai, utna completely 100% artisan ko nahi pass on hota, wo ho bhi nahi sakta, because costs add hote, because processes add hote. Lekin ek jo ek हेल्दी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है वो ज़रूर होना चाहिए. सम प्रोएक्टिव आर्टिजन्स विल डेफिनेटली बेनिफिट, लेकिन ये एक ब्लैंकेट फॉर्मूला नहीं है हर आर्टिजन के अपलिफ्टमेंट का. वन इज सपोज टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट द मार्केट वॉन्ट्स, हाउ द क्लाइंट्स टेस्ट इज चेंजिंग, वॉट मार्केट आर दे गोइंग टू. इफ टूडे दे आर गोइंग टू मुंबई, टुमारो दे आर गोइंग टू दिल्ली, और मे बी डे आफ्टर दे go to Dubai, they should be skilled enough to be able to understand how these markets differ. Market mein le jaake unko exposure de diya. They are sitting right in front of the client. But are they equipped enough to study the client? Are they equipped enough to react according to that or act according to that study? Put their acts together? Are they equipped enough to come back and constantly upgrade their skills in terms of whatever is new coming to the market? Can they keep up to all those things which designers are expected to and should be doing? Every year we run a module of Chikankari where we call the most eminent of artisans here. Students learn all 32 stitches they are taught. We maintain that tradition. We are still very much patronizing Chikankari even in our fashion education. Because we know if a student is to work in Lucknow, half the employers will be chicken employers. So we can't ignore chicken and in the name of teaching fashion. Chicken and fashion have to go hand in hand if the fashion study has to be made relevant to the Lucknow scene. The problem areas exist in every field. It's not that the craft is in danger as such. The craft is in safe hands. Yes, there are certain things to be looked into. Today's generation is the kind of commitment that the senior artisans showed to the craft. That needs to be passed on. Those value system needs to be passed on. When we are saying we are training new generation artisans, let us also train them in the value system. Let us just not pass on the craft to them in terms of stitches. Let us pass on the whole package of ethics and value system with the craft. Then it is definitely in the safe hands.
So, आपकी ड्राइविंग गाने के हिसाब से चेंज हो जाती है?
मेरी तो हो जाती है, बाकियों को पता नहीं।
चिकनकारी के लिए बहुत अहमियत रहा है, बहुत अहमियत है ये कि मेरे जैसे दादी बुआ अम्मा हमारी लड़की बहुएं हम काफ़ी लोग बनाते रहे, बहुत अच्छा रहा है।
तो ये पीढ़ी पीढ़ी चलती, ये एक पहले कहूँ नूरजहाँ पहले रहे लेकिन अम्मा हरी बतावत रहे।
ये माँ बेटी को सिखाती है या सासू माँ बहू को सिखाती है, कैसे है?
नहीं, बेटी तो भाई अब घर में जैसे रही सयानी हुई है तो हुआ सीख ली, रहा खुआ तो अपने सासू सिखा ली। बस 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 गुफरान चुपो बस 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 समूह बनाओ, कैसे तुम आगे बढ़ो, कैसे तुम समझो। तो अब ये जब जई जो बड़े वाले मिले हमसे, हाँ जो मिले इतना अब नीट चाहे जहाँ हम कह गए चेन्नई गए बम्बई गए दिल्ली गए, चार पैसा मेरा आदमी कमाता है तो हम कमा रहे हैं तो उनका उनका हाथ बटी हुआ। ये तीन पीढ़ी से हमारी लोगों चली आ रही है, तीन पीढ़ी कि दादी अम्मा ठीक है हम, अब हमारी पीढ़ी हमारी बहुरिया ले हैं तो अभी चौथी पीढ़ी चली है।
Asma Begum had been the leader of the artisans group. Today, she trains women in chikankari, helping them turn it into a gainful occupation.
अभी पोती छोटी है लेकिन सीखी है, एक थोड़ा बड़ी हो रही है तो वह काढ़ रही है।
तो आपने सिखाया उनको?
हाँ, अब अपनी मम्मी उतरे अब सिखाती थोड़ा थोड़ा।
ये दीदी अब हमका हुआ है एक साल, यही महीने में हम यहाँ पर आए थे, हम सेंटर चला रहे थे यहाँ पर, हम सेंटर चला रहे हैं। वो जो बहुरिया कहे लगी कि अब हम बांट लें भाई, अब तुमका का है कौन तुम्हारे शादी घर में है और कौन तुमका अब शादी करना है, तो हम कहें ठीक है। तो हमसे जब लड़ी रहे हैं तो हम अपने छोड़ दें, जब छोड़ दें तो हम सरकारी क्वार्टर में यहाँ रहे, सरकारी क्वार्टर में जब रहें
तो वहाँ जब है हमारी मतलब क्या माफी क्या नहीं रहे प्रधान तो वहाँ में से निकाल दिया। तो हम कहने यार अब कहाँ चली, तो कहें सेंटर हम ई प्रधान का घर है, तो कहें सेंटर हमारे यहाँ चलाओ और हमारे यहाँ जगह खाली पड़ी वही हम रहेगा, नहीं सेंटर चला नहीं हम रहेगा। तो हमका एक साल हो गया जब सुई उठाए, तो तीन साल मतलब हुए अब हमका, अब हम बनाए लेते हैं। समझा लो कि बेटी ऐसा है कि काम जो कर ले हो तो कोई दिन तुम खाना बना ले हो, रोटी दाल जो बनाओ बना ले हो, और तो छाही में यहाँ बढ़िया बैठे हो और बढ़िया धीरे धीरे कह रहे हो काम। तो कहें कहें कि अरे ना ही परेशान हो जाओ, तुम इन परेशान नहीं हुए, चार पैसा है आदमी से नहीं, कहते हैं सो डालो साबुन लाओ। कहें जब यह बात है तो हम फिर कह लेगा काम, पर धीरे धीरे कर ली। अब कहत रहे दीदी कहूँ से ना ऑर्डर हो तो हम कर दियो, कोई कहे चाची ऑर्डर हो तो हम कर दियो, तो हम कहना ऑर्डर देखो मिली है वो ऑर्डर, अब काम किए हो तो कोई दिन ऑर्डर वही है। ये बात उनसे
मतलब पुराने फैमिली के लोग अभी नहीं करते क्या?
पुराने वाले नहीं करते, क्यों? ये नहीं बनते, वो कहते हमको आँखें से अब डोरा डालने में थोड़ा परेशानी आ होते है। अब नहीं चलो ठीक है, अब जब पुराने काढ़ाते काढ़ाते छक गए हैं, अब नए रोशनी कम पड़ गई है, तो अब नए लोग सीखेंगे। अब जब नए लोग सीखे हैं तो वो जब अपने बच्चे के यहाँ तो सीखी हैं, ये पीढ़ी दीदी चली गई है। जैसे भी पहले मुस्लिम लोग करते रहे, अब तो हिंदू मुसलमान करते रहे।
वैसे कितने दिन का ट्रेनिंग?
40 दिन की। हम इनके घर घर के इनका बताए जोड़े, तो कहें ठीक है हम करेंगे। तो एक 30 लोगन का चला रहा है आधा बैच, ये 60 लोगन के बैच चला रहा है।
तो आपको ये अभी आसान लग रहा है या?
नहीं, मुश्किल कोई नहीं है। आप जो है जब जो चाहता तो घर पे करते हैं काम।
लेकिन आपको इसमें इंटरेस्ट है इसके मतलब?
हाँ।
अब इसमें सीखने क्यों आए दीदी, इस कला को सीखने क्यों आए आप?
सीखने लाभ के लिए आया।
क्या लाभ है?
क्या लाभ है कि अब माने चलो 40 दिन सीखा रहे, अपना काम किया रहे, फिर भी 1700 रुपये मिला रहे।
ट्रेनिंग के बाद अपने घर पर हम लोग बनाते हैं, काम कर रहे हैं,
पर जैसे घर का काम होगा फिर यही काम करे थे शाम तक।
हम सबको सिखा, कुर्ता बनाते हैं। हाँ, और बिहार की ये भाषा हमारी नहीं समझ पाती रहा।
ओ,
ये तो ना बोलते,
अब तो यहाँ बोले लगी। पहले हम एक ही भाषा हम नहीं समझ पा रहा, और हमारी भाषा ही नहीं जानती रहा। हम हिंदी भाषा, ये अपनी भाषा, लेकिन सुई से इशारे से सब काम हुआ।
तो इस बार इंटर का एग्जाम है तुम्हारा?
जी।
तो एग्जाम पढ़ाई के साथ ये काम अच्छी तरीके से कर सकती हो कि कभी कभी क्या करना होता है?
कभी कभी आपकी मतलब पैसे की कमी थी, इसीलिए एक कुर्ता ले लिया। विद्या क्वेश्चन लेना था इसीलिए।
बड़े होके क्या बनना चाहती हो?
टीचर। अगर हुनर है तो कदर है, हुनर नहीं तो कदर नहीं।